Oh, yes. Hello again. Welcome to School Around the Corner in the heart of the lands of Saints and Scholars in Armagh. That's where we are. We're visiting the Saints and Scholars Integrated Primary School. Indeed, look out for the saintly behaviour of these keen weather watchers.
In our school, we have 90 girls.
Yeah!
In our school, we have 110 boys.
Yeah!
And all together, we are...
Why do they call you Mrs. Giggle Woman?
Because I laugh all the time.
What's your favourite programme on TV?
School Around the Corner.
Do you watch it all the time?
It's not on all the time.
Yes, wonderful place. Now, is he a saint or scholar, or is he both? Welcome from the reception class, little Tom Creaney. Hello, Tom. Come on over. When you grow up, Tom, what are you going to be?
A cowboy.
And what will you need to be a cowboy?
Guns.
And what else does a cowboy have?
It has it. A lasso, it's a rope.
A lasso, yes.
And a horse.
Uh-huh. What does he use the lasso for?
It's for tying around his cow's head.
And when it goes round the cow's head, what does he do?
He pulls it.
Why would he do that?
Because he's a cowboy.
What's your favourite programme on TV, Tom?
Dinosaurs. There's a whole group of them, isn't there?
Yes.
Hungry.
What are they called?
Pachytosaurus. It has a bigger crest with two eyes, look like patterns. And it has two horns, two long sharp spines.
And do you have any other names for the dinosaurs?
Plateosaurus.
And how do you spell that?
Don't know.
You're beaten on that one. I see you've no laces in your shoes, but do you know a poem about shoelaces?
I can tie my shoelace, I can brush my hair, I can brush my teeth too, and fasten up my foot. I can say, how do I do and pull up both my socks?
What's that last wee bit?
Pull up both my socks.
Oh, right. What does your daddy do?
He works.
What does he work at?
He works at work.
Yes, he would. What sort of work does he do?
He's an ambulance man.
Does he drive the ambulance?
What
sort of noise does the ambulance make?
Nino, Nino.
Would you like to be an ambulance driver when you grow up?
I'm going to be a cowboy.
Of course you're going to be a cowboy. You're one of the best I've ever had on this programme.
I'm gonna get a wee puppy when I grow up. I'm going to look after it.
Are you going to put the lasso round it?
No.
Oh, you couldn't do that, so you couldn't?
No.
You have to look after it.
Yes.
Better than that, even if you are a cowboy.
Yes.
But Tom, who's coming up next on School Around the Corner? Whisper it into my ear. Is she good? It's the number of pupils from P4 to P6, the Tin Whistle Group, with the star of the county down.
Thank you.
deserving of the applause. And now it's hello to Corey Such and Kelly Balding. Come on over. Corey and Kelly, are you good friends?
Yes.
Are you good friends or very good friends?
Very good friends.
And would you say that you love each other?
Yes.
Oh! Who are you going to get married to when you grow up? To Corey?
Yeah.
And what do you think about that, Corey?
Very good.
You're all in favour. What's so special about Kelly, Corey?
She's got a beautiful face and beautiful hair.
She certainly does. And Kelly, what's so special about Corey?
Don't know.
What's the best thing about him? Is he funny?
Yeah.
Does he tell jokes?
Yeah.
Do you have a joke you're going to tell us, Corey?
I've got loads of jokes.
Go on, tell me a joke.
I make ones up now.
Well, you make one up and then Kelly can tell one.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Frank.
Frank who?
Frankenstein.
You tell me one.
Why wouldn't the skeleton jump off the cliff?
Why wouldn't the skeleton jump off the cliff? Tell me.
Because he had no guts.
Oh, he had no guts, he didn't. You've got a beautiful accent. Did you always live in Armagh?
No.
Where did you used to live?
England.
What do you like best about living in Northern Ireland, Kelly?
Playing out in the front.
So, which games do you play now with Corey?
I don't live with him there.
Oh, not yet. But you will.
Yeah.
When you get married to him, how many children will you have?
Two.
Oh, you say two, you say ten. Ten.
No.
Hey.
Yes.
No.
Ten.
No.
Ten.
No.
Ten.
No.
Ten.
Two.
Ten.
Two.
Ten.
Ten.
Two.
Ten. Two.
Marriage guidance? Any marriage guidance counselors?
Ten.
Settle for five, will you?
No.
No, ten.
Two.
Ten.
Two. Then you look after ten and I look after two.
Yeah.
You know, all I can say, Kelly and Corey, is I hope you have a very happy life together. Because you're a colourful couple. And who's coming up next on the programme, Corey?
I don't know.
But it's good, isn't it? As a matter of fact, it's very good. It's the cheerleading. It's Mamba number five.
I watched you before.
Jump up and down and move it all around. Shake your head to the sound. Put your hands on the ground. Take one step left and one step right. One to the front and one to the side. Clap your hands once and clap your hands twice. And if it looks like this, then you're doing it. A little bit of Monica in my life. A little bit of Erica by my side. A little bit of Rita's all I need. A little bit of Tina's what I see. A little bit of Sandra in the sun. A little bit of Mary all night long. A little bit of Jessica, here I am. A little bit of you makes me your man.
Yes, you're very welcome back to School Around the Corner from Saints and Scholars Primary School here in Armagh. Next up, it's Ben Ward from Primary 2 and Mark McSorley from Primary 1. Look at this man here. Ben.
Yes?
Were you in the hospital?
Yes.
When?
Today.
And you came all the way from the hospital to be on School Around the Corner.
Yes.
Hold on, like this man, to stop eating the mic. Oh, and it doesn't bite. Why were you in the hospital, Ben?
Because I had a sore eye.
How sore is it?
It's very sore now.
What happened it?
I was playing about with an elastic band and it broke and it twinged my eye.
A very dangerous thing, isn't it? Let me see. Oh, it looks so sore. I feel very sorry for you, Ben, but I'm very honoured that you would still come and appear on the programme. Have you ever been in the hospital, Mark?
Only the time when I was in the hospital when my brother was...
Your brother was born? And what's his name?
Matthew.
What age is Matthew?
8 months.
Oh, that's a handful, isn't it? What way does he make noise in the middle of the night? Is it as annoying as that? And does Daddy get up and look after him?
No. He just stays in bed.
And who gets up?
Mommy.
Good old Mommy. And Ben, when you grow up, what are you going to be?
A policeman.
And where will you work?
In Dobbin Street.
There are a lot of people in Dobbin Street that need an eye kept on them.
My granddad and I live there, and so is my dog Scampi.
And what's Scampi like?
He likes to run to me.
And when he runs to you, what does he do?
Licks me.
And do you lick him back?
No.
You wouldn't want to do that. You could end up in the hospital again, wouldn't you? Do you know what cool means, Mark? What is cool?
Daddy says that.
Does he have any other names for you, your daddy?
He just calls me Skiddly.
He calls you Skiddly? Tell me why your daddy calls you Skiddly.
My mummy calls me Painty.
Painty and Skiddly. And what would your mummy call this fella?
My brother.
Yeah, what does she call your brother?
Matt the Rat.
Have you any nicknames, Ben?
No.
Do you have a favourite football team, Ben?
Yes.
Which is your favourite team?
Man United.
Super team. Which is your favourite, Mark?
Liverpool.
Oh, we'll not get into that in case we fall out. Here, one for you as he puts the thumbs down. And one for you, Mark. What's coming next, Ben?
Coming next is our school's own boy band. They are called Simply Scholars.
Simply Scholars, doing the old boy band tune.
Expect to see those fellas on every music show very soon indeed. Now we meet Ashley Hughes and Oliver Mackell. On round here. Up round here.
When you grow up, Oliver, what are you going to be?
Have
you any idea at all what you might like to be?
I work in my daddy's factory, the apple factory.
And where is that?
Beside our house.
And that, of course, is in good old County Armagh, isn't it? The Orchard County.
Yeah.
And what does your daddy do in the apple factory?
He buys all the lorries.
How many lorries does he have?
Four.
That's four lorries. And where does he send the apples to?
England.
Can you eat the apples, or are they for juice?
Cooking and juicing and eating.
Cooking, juice and eating. Aisling, what are you going to do when you grow up? Do you have any pets?
I used to, but they both died.
Oh dear. Tell me about your pets that died.
One was Daddy's and one was mine. And one got a bit sick and the other just ran away.
Oh, what were they?
Dogs.
And tell me about the one that got sick.
Lucky.
Oh, he wasn't very lucky, was he? Have you ever been on any of the farms in Armagh, Oliver?
Not that many.
Would you like your daddy to have a farm?
He already does.
Does he? Where does he have the farm?
Down south.
Does he have animals on the farm or does he have apples on the farm?
Apples.
So it's an orchard in the south? And does he take the apples from the south to the factory in Armagh?
Yeah.
Do you know anything about racing pigeons, Alison? Do you know anybody who has racing pigeons?
Daddy.
Your daddy has racing pigeons. And what does he feed them on?
Pigeon food.
And how does he look after them?
Pigeon sheds.
How many pigeons would he have?
Hundreds.
Hundreds of pigeons that you look after well, and your daddy has so many apples, you've lost count of them. We have a pigeon certificate for you, and in here, an apple certificate for Oliver. And coming next here on School Around the Corner, it's drama. It's an appropriate apple theme, the core of the problem.
The core of the problem. There was a king in early life who feared that illness would take his wife. The young and beautiful Queen Branya, who suffered dreadfully from insomnia.
What can we do?
The king did weep.
If Branya doesn't get her sleep, she wastes away with every day and very soon will pass away.
But by chance, a wandering physician did come to hear of the queen's condition. He quickly hurried to the king, saying,
Your Majesty, I have the very thing.
So without delay, he sped afar to the beautiful county of Armagh, where legendary magic apples grow.
These will make the Queen's cheeks glow.
Three large Bramleys were baked in a pie, and Branya was offered a slice to try.
I hunger not, yet this contribution could surely be my last solution.
The rest is history. The Queen revived.
These apples have saved my life, and to their source I bestow my bounty, to ancient Armagh, the Orchard County.
The moral of the story's plain, if ever you should suffer pain, blood disorder or bad mood, just try a Bramley. They're exceedingly good.
They're the real thing.
And finally on the couch from Saints and Scholars, it's Nikita McFarland and Aisling McHugh. Aisling and Nikita, what's the best holiday you've ever been on, Nikita?
Lanzarote.
Did you have to go in an aeroplane?
Yeah.
Was the sun shining?
Yeah.
Seems like a good place.
And Aisling, what was the best holiday you've ever been on?
Portneuf.
Whereabouts is Portneuf? Did you have to fly or did you go in the car?
Go in the car.
It's not too far away, so it isn't. What did you do there?
Played with a bucket and a spade.
The best sort of holiday, the good old bucket and spade. If you had a magic wand, what would you wish for?
A Santa Claus.
A Santa Claus of your own? And what did he bring you the last time there?
Lots of things.
Was he very kind? What's your favourite story, Aisling?
Goldilocks.
Goldilocks and the Seven Dwarfs, I love that. Is that the one? Which one is it?
Goldilocks and the Three Bears.
And what happens in that? Goldilocks and the Three Bears. That's where they eat the gingerbread house.
No. What happens in Goldilocks and the Three Bears?
They eat the porridge.
They eat the porridge, is right. And then they throw the long blonde hair out of the castle window, isn't that right?
No.
Who's that does that?
Rapunzel.
Oh, yes, I
And I'm looking at you, and I don't know whether you're Rapunzel or Goldilocks with that beautiful hair you have.
And who reads the Goldilocks story to you?
Mummy.
And does she do all the sounds? Does she say, "Who's been sleeping in my bed?" Is she a good mommy? Is she a good mommy or a very good mommy?
A very good mommy.
You couldn't say nicer than that. And what about you, Nikita? What's your favourite story?
Little Red Riding Hood.
Oh, Little Red Riding Hood. Now, I know that one. She built a house with straw, didn't she?
No. The wolf was behind the tree, and then it was called Little Girl, Little Girl.
I'll blow your house down.
No.
I'm
the three pigs.
The three pigs, I see. I'm totally lost. I'd be totally confused, I would. But I'll tell you, I'm not so confused that I won't give you the wrong certificates. Yes, there's one there for Goldilocks, and there's one for Little Red Riding Hood. Well done indeed, and thank you for being on the programme. Did I get them the wrong way around even at that? And thank you very much for joining us. Yes, I've certainly enjoyed myself here at Saints and Scholars. Don't forget, next time around, we could be at the school around the corner from you. Bye-bye. Yeah.